RC phase shift control. A figure shows the RC phase shift control. Now it consists of one step down transformer whose secondary winding is center tap. Now as shown in this figure, one variable resistance R and one fixed capacitor C is connected in this in the series. That means it becomes RC series circuit. Now this series circuit or series combination is connected to the secondary winding of the transformer between terminal A and B. So now here C and D point is nothing but the gate and cathode voltage to the rectifier or to the SCR. Now when the AC supply is applied to this primary winding of this transformer, which induces EMF in the secondary winding. So now due to this EMF and closed circuit, current I is start to flow from this circuit. So here you can see AB, this is the voltage applied, the secondary voltage drop in the secondary winding. Now the current passing through this circuit, in this RC series circuit, which is lead. This current is lead by voltage V by angle phi, because here we are using capacitor. So here you can see the current is leading by this voltage an angle of alpha. Now when current passing through this resistance, when current passing through this suppose capacitor, the voltage drop appear across this capacitor, VC is equal to I into XC. So here you can see B and D, it is nothing but the voltage drop in the capacitor. Now the same amount of current passing through this resistance. So due to this voltage drop occurs in the resistance VR, which is in phase with current. So that is it and D, it is nothing but it is a voltage drop across this resistance. So here alpha, it is nothing but it is a angle between voltage and current. Now the phi, it is nothing but it is a angle between anode voltage and gate voltage. CD, that is your gate, the voltage across the gate and cathode terminal of the SCR. Now we are using center tap transformer, so we can write AC is equal to CB or BC. Now here we can write tan alpha is equal to BD divided by AD. AD here. AD divided by BD, that means IR divided by IXC. II cancel, so alpha is equal to tan inverse omega RC 2 pi FC, similarly omega RC. So here S AC is equal to BC. Here you understand 1 upon XC, it is nothing but 1 upon omega C. So that's why it becomes omega C RC. As AC is equal to CB and the angle phi, it is nothing but 2 alpha. Just put the value of alpha in this equation. So our equation becomes phi is equal to 2 in tan inverse omega RC. So now if we are increasing the value of the resistance, ultimately it increases the voltage drop across this resistance. That means VR is equal to I into R, and it decreases capacity voltage drop in the capacitor. That means VC is equal to I into XC. Now due to this phi, as a result, the phi phase angle phi is increased. So due to this increase in phase angle, the firing angle phi 1 of the SCR is also increased, which reduces the current IDC.